Hello, my name is Vincent Baidu. I run an organization called South Blessed and also Crown Root. We make lots of different stuff, including the Indigo Babies comic. And this video is just about males writing for main female characters. Now, there's a couple reasons why I'm bringing this up. And obviously, in the mainstream media, it is no surprise to anybody that females are quite horribly represented quite a lot of the time. But mainstream media isn't all media, and obviously there's a lot of different things that people are consuming, and they're created by a lot of different people, and those people who are creating them are creating a variety of worlds quite a lot of the time. They're not even human. So the first reason why I'm bringing this up is I just finished watching The Last Airbender, Avatar: The Last Airbender. Then I went and I bought the this one here, this comic, and then it goes into the next season, which is the Legend of Korra. Now, I'm not going to go into too much what it's about, but essentially, they've gone from one main character to another. So they've kind of transferred through the ages, and the Avatar is something which is cross-generational and switches between different genders, and that was clear from the first one. Now, the first one had the main character was male, and this one in the Legend of Korra, the main character is female. And there's a few different reasons why I prefer the original, but at the same time, after reading the comic which goes in between it, I am enjoying the series, but there's some differences that I'm seeing, and I think it's also interesting the fact that this new one, the two main writers are male and it's like a female character. Now, the thing that kind of got me thinking about this is the fact that in the first Avatar, in The Last Airbender, there are three series that happen. And the whole way through, it's clear that there is like a love interest, but it's kind of kept to quite a docile level. It's just a few comments here and there, and then towards the end of the series, it kind of gets brought up a little bit more. Going into this Legend of Korra, instantly, it's one of the major focuses is that aspect. Now, in the first Avatar, he's quite a young boy, and that's one of the main aspects of the whole thing is that he's come through and he's really young, and as avatars go, he's quite a young one. And this Legend of Korra one, she's meant to be more of a teenager, so it is kind of arguable that that's kind of one of the reasons why they kind of brought it up. But I think something that I found interesting is that in the Legend of Korra, she has like a romantic struggle in the sense that the guy that she likes is already with a girl, and you kind of get this standard sort of a drama thing that kind of plays out. Now, for me, I wasn't rating that as much because it seemed like a much more mainstream way of dealing with things that, like, the female is like just concerned with guys all the time, and she's got to fight another female to be able to get her man, so to speak. Now, it is possible that it's because I'm a man and I'm watching it, and that females who watched it might actually empathize with the situation and say actually it was quite well done, which is the main reason why I did this video. It wasn't actually because I had any like answers about anything. I'm just interested in it, and that's the second reason why I'm bringing it up is there's an artist which I'm hoping to work with. And what I'm doing at the moment is the artist that I'm hoping to work with, I'm creating stories, creating transmedial stories, planning out a few episodes, getting things sketched out, maybe one or two episodes in sketch format with panels and text and all of that sort of stuff, then getting some concept images designed, and then bringing it to the artist. So I've just got my table sorted out for an anime event in London in February, and hopefully she's going to be there. Now, her particular style of art, she only draws females. So what I like doing at the moment is because Indigo Babies is just like my out and out everything, all my inspirations is in Indigo Babies. But with everything else that I'm creating, with whatever person comes these certain limitations, and I'm kind of going with those limitations. So there's a comic that I'm making for a robotics company, and because it's a robotics company, obviously they want all ages involved. So that was my limitation in that one, was that I needed to make something that would be basically okay. It would be PC enough in terms of how it deals with issues so that a parent would be happy for their 5, 6, 7, 8 year old to read it. And with those limitations came different ideas because there are things that I wouldn't put in Indigo Babies because it was too kiddie, whereas actually here I had an opportunity to explore that childish world and come out with ideas that wouldn't fit inside of Indigo Babies. So I took the same stance with this one by creating a story that only had female characters, kind of brought something, brought different ideas to light into a way to do it. But the angle that I'm taking with it is that because all of the characters are female, there is no possibilities for love interest in that sense, or at least I'm taking that out of it. That's kind of what I'm choosing to do, is I'm choosing to create a story with females where it doesn't revolve around who it is that they're basically trying to engage with on a romantic kind of intimate level. Now, on one level, as other writers might say, that that's a bit of a scapegoat, and that's fair enough, and that's kind of the route that I'm choosing to do in this. But I suppose my only real question with this video is, do the females out there who consume different medias, especially like animes and comics and that sort of stuff, do they think that it's possible for males to create stories that are mainly based around female characters? And if they do, are there any examples for those successes? Because one thing that I've seen is that when females create stories which are just based around female characters, sometimes they can still appeal to men, just like when men create stories that are just about male characters, they can still appeal to females. So in the same way that the woman who created Powerpuff Girls, now as a youngster I used to quite like that. Actually, it's quite an anime kind of themed show, as compared, you know, I remember Powerpuff Girls and Samurai Jack, they were just kind of on that slightly more mangaish tip when watching the cartoons. So that was something that I've enjoyed. And I don't watch My Little Pony, but their main demographic is men, and that was done by the same person who created the Powerpuff Girls. So yeah, it's just to find out if people have any examples of shows that they know were either created by men but actually have all male casts, or more examples of shows that are females creating main female characters but then end up having wide appeal. Because as I'm creating this, I'm getting quite into the story that I'm making, and you know, I'm quite aware that it is kind of like a boy story but just with girls in it. I'm not trying to really indulge into what I'm perceiving as like fake femininity, and I can, you know, there's a lot of different other mediums and inspirations that I'm going to draw as it gets more detailed. And the artist that I'm hoping to get involved, she's a female. So, you know, if she wants to get involved, I'm hoping for her input. So it's not really specifically for this story, but no matter when you're watching this video, I'm always going to be interested in that. And I'm always going to be interested in watching any content or reading any mangas, watching any animes, any films, which are kind of on this theme. Because I think that, as I said at the beginning, generally the portrayal of women in mainstream media is pretty disgraceful. And so, you know, for people who are creating media purely based off other media, sometimes I think it can go, you know, a little bit skewed. And I'd also be interested in certain people's opinions specifically on the Avatar, Last Airbender, Legend of Korra. So I'm only one book, one season through The Legend of Korra. I don't doubt, you know, before November's up, I would have watched it all. So no spoilers as of yet. But yeah, if you've got any opinions on it, I would be real interested. And actually, it would be very, very helpful to me. So I would really appreciate it. So on that note, subscribe if you like the video. Go and check out some of the other videos. There's a Kickstarter at the moment if you want to check that out. You can download the Indigo Babies. And I just hope that you have a blessed day today.